In the numerator, again, here, we're going to invert and multiply, so I'm going to factor my numerator completely. The two factors of positive 35, whose sum is a negative 12, are minus 7 and minus 5. The q minus 8 stays where it is. And when I invert and multiply, the q gets moved to the numerator, and I am going to rewrite the order of this and factor out a negative. So I factor out a negative from 5, I'm left with a negative 5. I factor out a negative from negative q, I'm left with a positive q. So this right here would be my form that I factor it, and I also invert and multiply. So once I get into this form, I'm going to cancel any common factors. So my q minus 5s cancel. Nothing else cancels here. So my numerator, I get q times q minus 7. My denominator, I get q minus 8. And I have this negative sign. I'm going to move my negative up to the numerator. And so this would be my factored form. And now, when I look at my domain restrictions, I look at the denominator, any canceled factors in the denominator, which I see right here. But I also need to look in the inverted fractions, numerator, any variable factors that still remain, I have to account for those as domain restrictions. So I see here from the canceled factors that q can't equal 5. That's not apparent in the simplified form, so I include that. And then notice here, I have this factor that remains in the inverted fractions numerator. So I have to account for this. This can never be a 0. And the reason for that is when I go back to my original form, this inverted factor originally started in the denominator, right? So in this original form, could you take 5 minus q divided by q if q was 0? No. But that restriction is no longer apparent in our simplified form, so we have to include that as an additional domain restriction. Okay. So not only do you look for the canceled factors, but if you are dividing and you invert and multiply, any factors that remain in the numerator of that inverted form, you have to account for domain restrictions at those values as well, at those zeros.